Congressman, thank you so much for being with us.
Thanks, Alex.
There are so many people that are hurting right now. They're out of work. They're wondering, what are they going to do about their money? What specifically does this do for them?
Well, the bill that is being negotiated, both in a bipartisan and a bicameral situation and working with the administration as well, is moving in a lot of different directions. So we don't know exactly how it's going to pan out. To me, I think the two major areas that we have to focus on is taking care of workers, all workers, whether they are hourly, salary, gig workers, or commission-based. We have to set up unemployment that provides for full salary benefits, full wage benefits for up to 6 months, and that may need to be extended further. Simultaneously, we have to make sure that we have loans in place at zero interest or low interest or potentially even grants for small, mid-size, and large corporations to make sure that they can survive this time period and be in a position to thrive afterwards and be able to allow these workers to come back to their jobs.
Congressman, I'm wondering how you're going to manage the outbreak in the chambers. In other words, there are a couple people, I guess, that have tested positive that are in the House. And now the Congress has gone home and they're coming back and may have been exposed. How are we going to manage that in the Capitol building?
Dr. Drew, you raise a great point, and there's probably no place quite like Washington, D.C., where elected officials have constant contact with people from around the world. And you know, we're shaking hands, and we're all going onto the floor to vote with 400-plus other members. So this is going to be difficult. We are having more and more members test positive, as you know from the news reports, numerous other members who are self-isolating at this time. And so the full extent, we don't know what the impact is yet, and we're still trying to work through what it might mean for voting as we move forward.
So just to clarify, though, on that rescue plan, you said that you're looking for full salary. So that means we're hearing about this like $1,200 a month. If you make more than that, you would then get more than that? Is that how it would work?
Is that employment insurance?
Yeah, so let me be clear here. This is what I'd like to see, because I think this is what we need. These are times that we have never seen anything like this in our lifetime. And if we want to provide the economic security that individuals need, we need to do something along the lines I'm proposing. But I also recognize I'm one of 435 members of the House. We've got 100 senators, and we have an administration. So there's a lot of opinions out there. What I don't like about this concept of paying $1,000 or $1,200 to every individual making $75,000 or less, that does not take into account the cost of living by location. So obviously that money goes a lot further, say in Iowa, than it does in Orange County or LA County. And it also is a one-time payment. It doesn't really recognize that these people might be out of work for 3 months, 6 months because of issues completely out of their control.
Right. And the cost of living here is so much higher than you see almost anywhere
exactly.
else in the country.
And there.
Congressman Rouda, thank you. You're actually going to stay with us, which we're grateful for. Good to have you back with us. We talked a moment about this. Two of your colleagues in Congress have tested positive for coronavirus. We're talking about Republican Mario Diaz-Balart of Florida and Democrat Ben McAdams from Utah. They revealed that they have tested for it. What's the process now? Because we have not really seen in the past ever before where Congress works remotely or you vote remotely. Is that actually being discussed right now, a way to potentially work or vote from home?
It is potentially. Right now, we are working, as many Americans are, through teleconferencing. So I've been on numerous calls virtually every day as we work through what we want to see in this bill. But there is discussions as to when we have to be back in D.C. to vote. Are we going to be able to do that remotely at some point?
Yeah, that would be something.
And Congressman, you just had a town hall meeting with your constituency. I'm wondering what was on their mind. What are they most concerned about?
Dr. Drew, the number one thing that everybody has on their mind, they're scared, they're anxious, they're worried, they're concerned. And that came through loud and clear as far as their jobs, as far as the economy in general, how to take care of those who are most vulnerable, making sure that vets and senior citizens and the homelessness are being addressed. And also just getting back to some level of normal times again and what that might look like and when that might happen.
And that was a virtual town hall. We want to make everybody aware of that. That was on the Facebook page. So we're talking about this big legislation, this $1 trillion bill. sort of where are we at? What's the hang-up right now for this happening? Because we haven't seen a crisis like this. What's the sort of stumbling block in getting this stuff done?
I wouldn't say there's a stumbling block or a challenge in getting it done per se, because we're talking $1 trillion, and it may end up being much more than that.
Wow.
And you know, you got to figure out how you're going to spend $1 trillion in the right way. And I'd say the separation right now is that the Republican Senate version is more focused on bailouts for large corporations, and the Democrats are pushing back and suggesting and pushing for greater support for workers and small businesses.
So what sort of timeline, if I'm at home and I'm like, I need help now, we've seen millions of people filing for unemployment this week, what sort of timeline before somebody can actually get relief?
Well, keep in mind, we've already passed two pieces of legislation, the most recent one with over $8 billion, which I know is nothing compared to $1 trillion legislation that we're talking about now. But I would anticipate, based on the fact that both parties and both houses and the administration recognize how important this is, that we should see something pass within the next few weeks.
All right. And it'll be interesting to see if that's passed remotely. We've never seen anything like that before, but we've never seen anything like a lot of this before.
Let me just say, it's absolutely true. But thank you for the Congress for stepping up. I mean, seeing our government function is just one of the great reliefs and really something positive that's come out of this mess.
Well, as Winston Churchill said, you can always count on the United States to do the right thing after it's exhausted every other option.
Great way to end that segment. Thank you very much, Congressman Harley Rouda from Orange County. Stay healthy, stay safe. Come